So the next operation, the next game we'll do is we want to multiply integers, okay? And again, let's look at cases, okay? Let's look at the case first where we have what? One positive. I think I messed up my numbering, but it's okay, you know where we are. One negative. And let's start with small numbers, okay? So if I have a positive number, let's say what? Let's say 4, all right? Mm-hmm. I want to multiply this. Well, you guys know that this little x could stand for multiplication. Let's stick to this for now, okay? Of course, eventually you have to graduate to this. Okay. I don't know, which one do you want to use? The dot? Yeah. You don't want the x? Okay.
Let's do the vertical.
I know, yeah, because when you go to algebra, which we'll actually do in day 3, right? On day 3, we'll do the x. Okay. 4 dot is multiplication, right. And let's say I have negative 2. All right? In fact, sometimes you might even see this like this. Do you guys understand?
Yeah.
Sometimes they don't even put the dot, there's no dot, so the understood operation is multiplication. Right. All right? So let's go back to the definition of multiplication, which is multiplication is really repeated
addition.
What operation?
Addition.
Multiplication is really nothing but repeated addition. All right? So if somebody asks you to multiply 4 times negative 2 and you don't know how to do it, okay? So you say, what he or she wants me to do is to add negative 2 how many times?
4 times.
4 times. So it's negative 2. Plus negative 2, plus negative 2, plus negative 2. All right? And we just learned how to add, right? If everything you're adding is negative, they're all negative, right? So what's the answer?
Positive.
No, wait, we just learned it.
Negative.
If you're adding 4, if you're adding negatives, right?
Uh-huh. You're going to be negative 2.
Right? Okay? So it's going to be negative. You only have sad people in the room. Right? So you have 8 sad people. Hmm. All right? So if you know that, let's give you another example and then maybe you can give me an aha. All right? So if you have, let's say, 3 times negative 6, what does that mean? Negative 6 plus negative 6 plus negative 6. So that's what?
Oops.
Negative 18. Right? You can also, of course, have it switch. Let's say if I have negative 5 times 4. Remember, we can switch the order. Mm-hmm. We learned that in arithmetic, right? It's commutative. Multiplication is commutative. What is the meaning of negative 5 times 4? You can think of adding what? How many times? You can think of adding negative 5 4 times, right? So it's negative 5 plus negative 5 plus negative 5 plus negative 5. What's the answer?
Negative 20.
So can we put the rule now? Do you have an aha?
Aha.
Okay. So when I'm multiplying one positive and one negative, the answer is always going to be negative. Okay? So the rule, which we'll just abbreviate here, is if I have a positive, I want to multiply by a negative, I'll get a negative. Likewise, if I have a negative, I multiply to a positive, I have negative. Clear? Just think of it because I'm just repeatedly adding negative numbers, okay? It gets a little bit tougher to explain what is the next case. If I have, not yet.
Two
negatives.
Yay.
When you have two negatives, so let's play, okay, with the negatives. So again, if I have, let's say, a negative 2 times what? A negative 3. Okay?
6.
Negative 2 times negative 3. And yeah, you know, Sharon knows it's positive 6, right? But why did it become positive 6?
Because 2 negatives is equal to positive.
That's the rule. You already know the rule, but
why? Why?
Why did it become like that? That's the rule, but why? What is the why? Well, we know, we just talked about a positive and a negative, right? If we forget that negative sign for a while, just look at these two, right? Forget the negative sign, correct? We have what? Positive 2 times negative 3 is how much? We just learned it. What's a positive
negative
times
six.
A negative? It's negative 6, correct? So you have, okay. So this thing here is negative 6, correct? But then you take the opposite of that negative 6, that's the exact notion. The opposite of a negative is?
Positive. Double negation.
Double negation. Again, I know Mike is seeing his plus sign, right?
Yeah.
See that? Minus, minus, plus. All right? Make sense? Okay. Do we need another example or we can put the rule already? So again, if you have, let's say, negative 6 times negative 4, what is the answer to this? Quickly?
24.
Positive 24. Understand? All right? So for two negatives, the rule is what? Negative times negative will always give me a
positive.
This is what you talked about earlier. You got confused with the positives. And when we were adding two negatives, the answer was negative, right? When you are multiplying two negatives, the answer is
positive.
I have a colleague in his book, he wrote something like this. That's correct, right?
Yes.
Negative times positive is what?
Negative.
Negative times negative is what?
Positive.
And of course, the basic thing that we know already is positive times positive is?
Positive.
I saw his book a while ago, okay? And in his book, he explained it like this. He said, a friend of my friend is my friend.
I've heard that.
Have you heard of this? You want me to do the next one?
Yeah.
Then maybe you can figure out what's happening next, okay? A friend of my enemy is my what?
Enemy.
Now, do you guys figure out, know what we're doing here?
Yeah, so you subtract.
A friend is positive, right? A friend of my friend is my friend. Right?
Mm-hmm.
A friend of my enemy is your enemy, right? I mean, of course, we should not be like that in real life.
It's very nasty.
That's nasty, I know.
That's high school.
It's in high school. Okay, so how will you say this if you were to try to have fun with this?
Enemy of my friend.
An enemy
of my friend.
Of my friend is my what? Is my enemy. Again, we should not follow this, okay? But it's just a way to remember. And then this one is what?
Enemy wins.
An enemy of my enemy
is my friend.
Is my friend. Okay? Of course, some of you will say it's easier for me to remember negative times negative is positive, right? Okay? But there are ways you can do this, okay? Any questions so far? You're okay?
Yeah.
And then the good news is we're down to the last operation, which is division. I don't really need to explain this so much. Okay? The good news is, what's the good news? If I have a positive, and let's start with what we know. If I have a positive and I want to divide it by a positive, what do you think is the answer?
Positive.
It's a positive. Another way of writing this is a positive on top, right? And a positive below. Isn't that another way of writing division, right?
Yes.
Positive divided by positive is?
Positive.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, how do you check division? Isn't it when you check division, you multiply these two? That's why I wanted to use this notation. Positive times positive is
positive.
Alright? So, if I have a positive and I want to divide by a negative, so let's look here, which you can also write like this. What should I pair with this guy so that this answer is plus? What should I multiply with this?
A negative.
A negative. Right? Okay? So, a positive divided by a negative is
a negative.
Alright? Or if I have a negative and I want to divide by a positive, again, maybe it's easier for you to see it here. If I have a negative, I want to divide by a positive. What should I pair with this over here? When I multiply this, will give me a negative.
Negative.
Do you know what I'm doing? I'm kind of thinking
positive
of the multiplication problem, right? It's
a
negative. Positive times negative is negative, all right? Negative over positive is
negative.
And then finally, if I have a negative and I want to divide by a negative, I get what?
Positive.
A positive. Again, oh, sorry, I ran out of room here. If you have a negative on top, a negative below, what should you multiply to this guy to give you a negative answer there? It's a
positive.
Well, if you look at the rules, actually I still have the multiplication rules here and the division rules here. Is there some aha that you can help you say, it's not really a big deal to remember the division rules? Anybody see the relationship?
The multiplication, right? They're basically the same.
They're basically the same, right? Mm-hmm. When you are multiplying or dividing two integers, how can we say it in English? When you are multiplying or dividing two integers that have the same sign, right? The answer will always be
positive.
If they have the same sign, the answer is positive, right? For two, okay?
Right.
If you have opposite signs, one is positive, the other is negative, then the answer is
negative.
You see it? Okay, is that an easy way to remember? So for multiplication and division, they need to have the same sign in order for you to get a positive answer. All right? Okay? And if the signs are opposite, then they need to be negative. Okay. We know all the operations now. Well, let's practice and see if you remember how to do this.